Hello everyone, welcome to Achievers IAS classes. Let's begin our discussion on the current events of 9th January 2018. The first issue in news is regarding the re-examination of the assassination of Mahatma Gandhi. The issue was in news because recently Mr. Amarinder Sharan reported to the Supreme Court that there is no substantial material evidence to justify a need to reinvestigate the assassination of Father of the Nation, that is Mahatma Gandhi. It was in response to a public interest litigation filed in the Supreme Court, which said that there was a British Secret Service conspiracy behind the killing of the Mahatma. Given the mammoth contribution of Mahatma Gandhi towards India's struggle for freedom, anything related to him is of utmost importance from the examination point of view. So I request you to go through the relevant history chapters related to the issue. Now let's move on to the next issue in news, which is regarding Section 377 of the Indian Penal Code, which criminalizes homosexuality. As we all know, the Delhi High Court had previously struck down the provision under Section 377, which criminalized homosexuality as unconstitutional. The Supreme Court set aside the Delhi High Court judgment and upheld the validity of Section 377. The issue is in use now because the Supreme Court has decided to refer the writ petition challenging Section 377 to a larger bench of the Apex Court. The petitioners argue that the right to sexuality, sexual autonomy, and the freedom to choose a sexual partner form the cornerstone of human dignity, which is protected under Article 21 of the Constitution. And the Apex Court has recently viewed that no section of the people should be forced to live in the fear of law in matters of their choice of natural sexual inclinations. It further said that societal morality changes with time and law too should change with it, thereby upholding individual autonomy and individual natural inclination. It further observed that what is natural differs from individual to another individual, and no law can curtail the right to life guaranteed under Article 21 of the Constitution. This is in line with the progressive judgments of the Supreme Court in the previous cases, like in the case of transgender identity in the Nalsa case, and the recently delivered verdict of the right to privacy of an individual. Given the growing voices for equality by the transgender community and the various social disabilities imposed on them, Section 377 definitely needs to be relooked, and will further look into it once the final judgment of the Supreme Court is out. Till then, let's move on to the next issue in news, which is about cybercrime. The issue is in news because the Ministry of Home Affairs is all set to launch a web portal where the victims of cybercrime could register complaints on a real-time basis. Any complaint regarding online abuse or even crimes like financial frauds could be registered on the web portal, and the central government also plans to give access of the portal to the banks to address the cases of financial frauds online. The portal has been designed based on the directions given by a committee appointed by the Supreme Court to check the circulation of child pornography and sexual violence videos on the internet. And given the rising incidents of cybercrime, it is a step in the right direction. The portal is also designed in such a way that women who face online abuse can simply upload screenshots of objectionable messages, videos, or audios. Also, there will be a separate section on the website where heinous content like child pornography or gang rape videos could be uploaded anonymously for further action. The center will also set up a central forensic laboratory where all the latest tools will be available and made accessible to the state agencies, giving the much needed teeth to these agencies to tackle cybercrime. With that, let's move on to the next issue in news, which is about the pictorial warnings on the cigarette packs. As we have seen in my previous videos, the Karnataka High Court had recently set aside the requirement of pictorial warnings covering 85% of the packaging space over tobacco products. In this regard, there were several petitions filed against the High Court decision in the Supreme Court, highlighting the rampant illiteracy in the country, which requires easier modes of dissemination of the harmful effects of cigarettes. And there is no better medium than the pictorial warnings on the cigarette packs. The petition further argued that, apart from the victim of the habit, the family of the victim too suffers, ultimately hurting the society as a whole, thereby necessitating the state to take measures to bring down tobacco usage. Given the rising levels of lifestyle diseases, particularly cardiovascular diseases, tobacco usage is a major public health concern, and we'll further look into the issue once the final judgment of the Supreme Court is out. The next issue in news is regarding the recent notification of the amended Companies Act by the government. There were various amendments to the original Company Act which were brought in to ease the implementation of the Insolvency and Bankruptcy Code, and I have covered all these in detail in my previous news analysis video. So those who have missed it, please go back and watch the same. The next issue in news is about the fastest supercomputer in India named Pratyush. It has a computing capacity of 6.8 petaflops and is the fourth fastest supercomputer in the world, following machines in Japan, USA and United Kingdom, which are exclusively dedicated to weather and climate research. And the primary function of the supercomputer is towards monsoon forecasting using a dynamical model. With that, let's move on to the next issue in news today, which is talking about the impact of US President Trump's statements on China-Pakistan ties. The news article is highlighting various new developments post Mr. Trump's remarks on Pakistan's support to terrorism, which could result in a slide in the ties between Pakistan and Washington and an eventual tighter embrace of Pakistan by China, which is evident in the fact that Pakistan's central bank recently announcing that it would use Chinese yuan to settle bilateral trade with China, which Pakistan so far resisted. Also, the remarks of Mr. Trump played into the hands of religious right groups in Pakistan like the Jamaat-ud-Dawa, which, as we have seen, is trying to enter Pakistani mainstream politics. The article further says that the remarks of the US president could be used by Pakistan to strengthen its ties with China and Russia. We'll further look into this issue as it evolves in the days to come. With that, I wrap up today's news analysis. Do like, share and comment to support the initiative. Thank you for watching. Have a nice day.